Hi, everybody.
Ready to cheer? This week, we are going to learn how we can cheer our friends on. So before we go on, get on those feet and sing with us.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello. Hey, hi, hello.
God gives me friends, and I can pray for them. Help them out and cheer them on. They can learn from me, and I can learn from them. This is why God gives us friends.
Jesus. He wrote a letter to the church in a place called Philippi. In Philippians chapter 4, Paul reminded his friends that it wouldn't always be easy to follow Jesus. Let's watch and see.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to the clubhouse. My name is Mia.
I'm Ezra.
And I'm Lily. And we are
the Super Crew.
And this is our friend Bark. Say hi, Bark.
Mia was just telling us about her concerts.
Yeah, I get to play my violin at a concert tomorrow. But I'm a little scared to be in front of everyone. What if I play the wrong note? What if they laugh at it?
Oh, Mia, you are so good at playing.
Yeah, Mia's violin playing is awesome. Mia, you have practiced so much, and I know you are going to do a great job. And don't worry, we will be there to cheer you on. Everyone, repeat after me. Let's start really quiet. Let's go, Mia.
Let's go, Mia.
Now, a little louder. Let's go, Mia.
Let's go, Mia.
Now as loud as you can. Let's go, Mia.
Let's go, Mia.
Thank you, friends, for encouraging me and cheering me on to be brave. Oh, did you hear that? It sounded like the super box. Let's go see.
Did you send us something super?
Yes.
Wonderful. Here at the clubhouse, we help connect the super clue, the big deal, and the Bible. Today's big deal is hey, hi, hello. God gives me friends. Let's see what's inside.
I know what that is. It's a foam finger. Whenever I go to a football game, I wear my foam finger to cheer on my team.
So, I wonder, what does a foam finger have to do with hey, hi, hello, God gives me friends. Will you wonder with us?
I think I know. A foam finger is something that you can use at a game to cheer someone on. We can cheer on our friends when they are happy or even when they are sad. I'm so thankful for my friends.
Now, be looking, because you are going to see the super clue again. When you see the super clue, here's what I want you to do. Since our super clue is a foam finger, I want you to hold up your pointer finger and say, "You're number one." Can you try it with me? See the super clue? Cheer on a friend and say,
"You're number one."
Good job. I know how we can learn more about cheering on our friends. Let's
look in the Bible.
Remember, the Bible is God's book.
The Bible is true, and it's for you.
Today's Bible story comes from the book of Philippians. Can you say Philippians?
Philippians!
In this Bible story, we will learn about a man named Paul who wrote a letter to some friends. His friends were feeling sad, and Paul wanted to encourage them. Let's look at the Bible story together. Paul gave hope. Paul wrote an important letter to his friends in the city of Philippi. He wanted to cheer on his friends as they followed Jesus with hearts that put others first, even when things were hard. Paul cared so much for his friends that he addressed them like they were his family. Paul wrote, "My brothers and sisters whom I long to see, stand firm in the Lord, dear friends." Paul encouraged his friends to stand strong and keep following Jesus. He also wanted his friends to agree to live in peace and work together. He encouraged two women who were disagreeing to agree and be true friends in telling people about Jesus. Paul continued to cheer on his friends. "Be joyful in the Lord always," Paul said. "You should treat others with gentleness and kindness so that everyone sees how much you love Jesus. The Lord is coming soon. Don't worry about anything, but tell God about everything. Ask and pray to God, thanking Him. And God's peace will watch over your hearts and minds because you belong to Jesus." Finally, Paul said, "Think about what is true, what brings honor to God, what is right and just, and what is pure and lovely. If there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Do what you have learned from me. Follow my example, and the God who gives peace will be with you."
What a great story! Paul wrote a special letter to encourage his friends and cheer them on. We can cheer on our friends to love God and to cheer on others too.
Our super clue! Do you remember what to do?
You're number one!
Great job! A foam finger can remind us to cheer on our friends. We can encourage our friends to love God and to love other friends too. So,
what have we learned? What have we learned? What have we learned today?
We have learned that God gives us friends, and we can cheer on our friends. In our Bible story, Paul remembered how his friends cheered him on, and he wrote a letter to give them encouragement. We can cheer on our friends to love God and love other friends too.
That is a big deal. Let's say our big deal together. I'll say it first, and then you say it after me. Hey, hi, hello.
Hey, hi, hello.
God gives me friends.
God gives me friends.
Great job.
God gives us friends, and we can cheer them on no matter what.
I loved it when you cheered for me. I've got an idea. We should make up cheers for each other.
Great idea, Mia. Thanks for joining us in the clubhouse. Say bye, Bark.
Bye!
Hey, friends. Let's learn a verse from the Bible that tells us how to treat our friends. Remember, the Bible is God's book. The Bible is true, and it's for you. Now listen and watch it first as we learn it together. Consider others as more important than yourselves. Philippians 2:3b. I want everyone to stand up so we can say the Bible verse. I'll say it first, then you can repeat it after me. Consider others.
Consider others.
As more important.
As more important.
Than yourselves.
Than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Philippians 2:3b.
This verse tells us that we should consider others. Consider means to think about other people. We can follow God by choosing to put other friends first. That means we can think of other people and help others when they need it. Let's say the verse again as you repeat it after me. Consider others.
Consider others.
As more important.
As more important.
Than yourselves.
Than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Great job. When we consider or think of others the same way we think of ourselves, we are showing them how much they matter. God has put so many people in our lives. When we consider them first, we can cheer them on, help them, or even learn from them. We can show them how great they are. Let's say it one more time, all together, but this time loudly with our cheering voices. Ready? One, two, three.
Consider others as more important than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b. God gives us friends. We can show them how much they matter by the way we treat them. See you next time.
It's not always easy to follow Jesus, but you can stand firm in your faith, just like the people in Philippi. They encouraged and cheered one another on. We can cheer on and encourage our friends too. Let's pray together. Dear God, thank you so much for helping us, for always being with us. And God, help us see the people around us who need some encouragement and who need to be cheered on, and help us be the people who do that. We love you so much. And everybody said,
Amen.
See you later.
Bye.